Welcome back to my channel, guys. I have another video for you. So I finally got my hands on the Huda Beauty palette, Rose Gold Edition. Finally got my hands on it, and it was sold out for a while, but as soon as it got back in stock, I went ahead and copped it. So I want to do a look today with this palette. I just don't really know what I'm doing yet. Sorry about the glare. I really don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna kind of wing it. I kind of have an idea what I want to do, but let's just hope it turns out right. So let's get started. I usually start out with face first, but I'm going to start with my eyes first. So, and girls, you know how it is when you get a sew-in for the first time. Today is the first day, your face is like snatched back like this, and your brows really ain't get used to your new hairstyle. That's what's going on right now, but we're gonna make it work. So I'm going to start out with filling in my brows with Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz. I'm using dark brown as my color. And when I start out with brows first, I'm not really gonna do the top of my brows. I'm just going to fill in mainly the base of my brow. Once I start applying foundation and powder and all of that, it disappears. Then you have to go back and fix it anyway. So I just pretty much start with the base first. This is my favorite brow right here on this side. It always works with me. This brow is like the stepchild. This is my brow that I like right here. Cause like now, the stepchild wanna act right, but the favorite wanna act like you don't know how to act. Now, I really don't got time today for no foolishness. So this is Benefit Air Patrol. Bring it up in the crease and let it overlap. And like one or two clicks goes a long way. You really don't need more than two clicks of this. Like two clicks might be too much for me today. All right, I'm just smoothing it out with my hands just a bit. I don't like to too much touch this. I like to keep it wet. Ooh, that ain't sound right. Anyways, we're gonna keep it PG, honey. Not doing all that on here. Let's go in with the eyeshadows. Don't know what I'm doing yet, but we gonna find out. And I'm going to start with this color right here. This color is called Sandalwood. It's a really pretty color. Anyways, I'm gonna start with Sandalwood M501 brush. And I'm using it because of this little point right here. Now I'm going ever so lightly over it with this Sandalwood color. This is my transition color, and it's also going to mattify my lids. I don't like putting loose powder over my eyes to mattify the primer, the eyeshadow primer, because it makes my eyelids even more drier. So I have to stay away from stuff that makes my lids drier, because then I'll have old lady lids,
old lady eyelids after my eye look, and that ain't cute.
I really like this color. I really like this pigment so far. I didn't know until after I bought this palette that there were mixed reviews for this palette. I guess some people were saying that it wasn't as pigmented, or shimmers weren't as pigmented. And I have already used this palette on my friend slash muse slash regular client. In fact, let me show y'all a quick video of her. She's so cute. Shout out to my boo. Yes, I used it on her and I really liked it, so. But this is the real test. So yes. Child, y'all don't want nobody to do their job here. Hunty.
I'm gonna go in with is Hannah.
This color right here, 217 brush. I'm going to add that color. Oh, look at that. It's pretty. So I'm basically just pulling out the eyeshadow out a little bit more, making it more exaggerated to make my eyes look a little bit bigger. And sometimes when I feel like my eyeshadow isn't blending, I'm not saying that's what's happening here because I'm not talking about the eyeshadow yet, I'm not talking about the palette yet, I do circular motions instead of just windshield wiper motions. So I'm going in with Coco and then I'm gonna go in with Man Eater, 562 brush. Yeah, I don't wanna talk about these shadows yet. And I'm going a little bit under the brown first. Like I'm kind of bringing Man Eater up into that brown color, Coco. So now I wish I would have started out with Man Eater first before I put Coco in. Because maybe Coco would have blended a little bit better. I don't know. It's looking very red and a hot mess right now, but stay with me. I think we can salvage this look. I really do. I think I'm going in with this color, rose gold. Oh wow, look at that. Came right off on my fingers. So let's try. Oh my gosh. Jeez. Wait a minute now. That's pigmented. Oh, jeez. Okay. Excuse me. I said I wasn't gonna say that. That's what I had said. Let me go to the other eye. Because this is so pigmented. Right here, this 24 karat gold in my inner corner, but look at these damn nails. Ain't gonna get in there, so I'm gonna have to use this brush, the 242 brush. Okay, I picked up a good amount on my brush and I'm gonna spray it with Fix Plus. And let's see if we can get it in there real good. Oh. Gonna go in with this pretty color, Bossy. Let's see. I'm gonna go use a 242 brush from MAC. Let's see. So I'm gonna do like a outer V. I'm gonna get a clean brush. Any clean brush will do. Blend out any harsh lines that I see. Going in with Henna right here. Eyes looking like a damn party, child. Going in with Inglot number 77. All right, I'm starting to feel a little bit better. Once I put my lashes on and fill out my brows, I think it'll be real cute. Almink Lashes. This style is called High Maintenance. They're really high maintenance. My face feels so dry after all of that work. I feel like I just did surgery on these dang eyes. Jesus.
Next, let's prime this face. I'm using Veil Primer from Hourglass. And then I'm using Smashbox Primer Water.
So I'm using a MAC 287 brush
and my Becca Under Eye Corrector, and I'm just pushing in the product.
Put some loose powder on my nose to prevent
any oils.
Okay, look like this. Hey girl, you ready? No, I'm not ready. I need a little bit more to do. Use my Makeup Forever HD foundation. Used to be my favorite brush back in the day, the F80 brush. Oh, used to be my favorite. But I'm finding with this foundation, this cream foundation is best applied with a brush instead of a beauty blender.
So I love this foundation because it's a dewy finish and it's full coverage and it matches my skin color exactly, and that is so hard for me to find.
And I'm just gonna go over my contour areas. A MAC 150 brush to blend that out.
One of my favorite brushes from MAC for cream contour. And I'm applying my nose contour with MAC Oval number 3 brush.
I'm going to use medium shape tape. Medium honey. Heart-shaped tape, and I'm going to
take my beauty blender and blend that out. Then I'm going in with MAC Pro Longwear NW20, and this concealer is my favorite concealer, my ride or die, no creasing.
And I do not bake. It doesn't work for me. So what I do is I tap my mini beauty blender in and I get about this much product. And then I tap off the excess on the back of my hand like that. And then I work from this. The first time I put my beauty blender on my face is on the outside of my under eye. That way most of the product goes there. And as I work my way inwards, it's less product.
And I'm using Secret Brightening Powder from Becca. And the trick to getting that flawless under eye is pushing in the loose powder until it disappears, until it looks like skin.
Now I'm going to set my whole face with the same loose powder that I used on my nose. And I'm using this MAC 187 brush.
I'm going to use this duo fiber brush and I'm going to mattify and set my face. And with my MAC 150 brush, I'm going to bring color back to my face. And then MAC Give Me Sun.
Same brush. And I'm just going to go over the hollows of my cheek and I'll bring it down just a bit. And I'm going to highlight my face.
And I'm staying away from directly under my eyes because I don't want that area to look dry.
This is the MAC 239 brush, and I'm going to use this brush to bring NC25 down the bridge of my nose. And I like to use a big brush for this step. And I just pack it on like that. I'm not too precise with my nose sometimes. It just depends on my mood. Then I'm going to go in with my Golden Peach from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I'm going to use that as an in-between color for me between the NC25 and NC42. I'm going to place that right there in between just to mesh that color in just a bit more. I don't want to be too highlighted. I just want it to be pretty gradual and golden. That's how I want it. And that's why I use that in-between color. So it's not like to a big jump from light to dark. It's just very subtle. And then I like to cut my contour with Golden Peach. Like that. See how subtle that is? I love it. And then I'm gonna take that Golden Peach from Anastasia Beverly Hills and push that in between the NC42 and NC25. And you see how that just blends in really nicely, just like that. Okay, and I'm gonna go back in with Sandalwood from the Huda Beauty palette and this small brush from Morphe. It's a M506 brush and I'm going to smoke out my lower lash line. Then I'm going in with a pencil brush. Any pencil brush will do from MAC. Is the one I'm using in the color Henna.
And I'm going to run this color really close to my lash line.
I'm sorry, I don't know if I want to put Man Eater in, but I'm going to put it in. Let's put it in. Smolder from MAC. And I'm gonna smudge it down with a flat brush from MAC 212.
And I'm going to smudge smolder in.
Look how pretty that is. I'm going to go over it with this black color in the palette, Black Truffle.
And I'm going to set smolder and bring down that color for a gradient effect.
Just so it kind of like blends. And then I'm gonna take that pencil brush again and I'm gonna go in with henna.
And I'm going to smoke it out even more.
Look at that. Makes such a difference. Okay, time to add highlight and blush. My favorite, MAC Fix Plus. Today, I think I'm gonna use Champagne Pop. Oldie but goodie. With my Japanese fan brush. Ooh, look at that, so pretty. I love Champagne Pop. I love nylon, it's so gorgeous. It's like a stark white. I only use it for my inner tear ducts. This is Melba. Let's add that one on my 168 blush brush. Love this. And now I'm going in with dark brown from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Palette. And I'm going to finish my brows. Then what I like to do is I like to wipe the brush off and then I like to go in with lighter color of the dark brown and I like to go lightly at the beginning of my brow like this so that they are more natural. Now I'm just creating brow hairs. Back and forth with the two colors, the lighter color and the darker color, so I get them to my liking. So I think I'm gonna go with maybe Trust Issues. Yeah, I think I'm gonna like this color with it.
Trust Issues from ABH. And a little Champagne Pop on top.
Okay, so here is the finished look. I really, really love this look. I love the way it turned out. At first, we had a couple bumps in the road, but thank God we were able to bring in the look and make it look so glamorous and so sexy and really exotic and kind of Arabic type look. And I'm really feeling it. You know, I would probably wear it on maybe like a girl's night, probably not date night because this is a little too much for me. But for some of you all that like to go glam out, this is the look for you. And I'm glad that I paired it with this color from Anastasia Beverly Hills, Veronica. I really do love this color. And then I put a little bit of the Champagne Pop in the middle that really set off the look. You can go with a nude color, that's up to you. You could have skipped the gold inner corner and just kept the rose gold. It's so many different ways you can tweak this look with this palette. But I'm really, really feeling it, and I hope that you guys are too. If you like this look, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me out, and it lets me know that you love what I'm doing and that we're growing together on my channel. So I can't wait to see you guys in the next tutorial, and I love you so much. That's done.